Still on the violence in Ecuador, authorities there presented 13 people detained over storming a live TV newscast Tuesday. They are investigating how the armed men obtained the weapons and explosive used during the assault. Meanwhile, three kinds of explosives were found inside the studios. Among them, stun bombs, military grenades, and dynamite sticks. Ecuador President Daniel Noboa not backing down against criminal gangs as a series of violent attacks rocks the country. Speaking on state television, Noboa said Ecuador is in a state of war against terrorism. He also named 22 gangs as terrorist organization, making them official military targets. Noboa also met with foreign diplomats who expressed support for the measures taken by his government, which declared a 60-day state of emergency. Now, over in Spain, the health ministry reimposes a nationwide mask mandate at health facilities. This as cases of COVID-19 and flu spike in the country and across Europe. The decision was made despite opposition from several Spanish regions. Spain's health ministry insists masking up is a basic and minimum measure that could protect the vulnerable population and contain the spread of diseases. The World Health Organization warns COVID-19 remains a major threat. The WHO said nearly 10,000 COVID deaths were reported in December. There was also a 42% increase in hospitalizations and a 62% increase in intensive care unit admissions last month. It says data from various sources point to increased transmission last month, fueled by the holiday gatherings and the JN.1 variant. The WHO now urges governments to maintain virus surveillance and sequencing and ensure access to COVID tests, treatments, and vaccines. Israel set to appear before the International Court of Justice to face accusations of genocide in its war against Hamas. South Africa took Israel to court in late December, saying it failed to uphold its obligations under the 1948 Genocide Convention. The hearings will deal with South Africa's request for emergency measures, ordering Israel to suspend its military actions in Gaza, while the court hears the merits of the case, a process which could take years.
The State of Israel will appear before the International Court of Justice to dispel South Africa's absurd blood libel. This despicable intervention to save the skin of the Hamas rapist regime is, as Secretary Blinken noted, also a distraction from important efforts to bring back the hostages, protect civilians, and prevent this conflict from spreading. We, the State of Israel, will not be distracted as we continue pursuing those essential goals.
Israel's air and ground offensive prompted by a cross-border Hamas rampage on October 7 has killed over 23,000 Palestinians. It also destroyed large areas from northern to southern Gaza. Israeli Prime Minister Benjamin Netanyahu issues a statement on the eve of the ICJ hearing. He said Israel has no intention of occupying Gaza, rebuffing calls from hard-hit ministers to rebuild Israeli settlements in the enclave.
I want to make a few points absolutely clear. Israel has no intention of permanently occupying Gaza or displacing its civilian population. Israel is fighting Hamas terrorists, not the Palestinian population. And we are doing so in full compliance with international law. Our goal is to rid Gaza of Hamas terrorists and free our hostages. Once this is achieved, Gaza can be demilitarized and de-radicalized, thereby creating a possibility for a better future for Israel and Palestinians alike.
Israel earlier said it's planning to begin drawing down troops at least from the northern part of Gaza as it shifts to a more targeted offensive. But the fighting appears to be as intense as ever. Well, let's find out what stories our North America Bureau is pursuing right now from our correspondent, Henny Espinosa.
Hey guys, your news making headlines in the Filipino community.
We begin with Los Angeles sheriffs seeking leads in the fatal New Year's Eve shooting death of 24-year-old Filipino Andre Nico Gianan. According to reports, on New Year's Eve, Gianan worked a shift at the San Pedro Wingstop before heading to Manhattan Beach. but by 1 a.m. on January 1st, he was fatally shot in the head at the 1400 block of 11th Street. There have been no arrests or suspects, and a motive has not been established. The family believes he was in the wrong place at the wrong time, and the Los Angeles Sheriff's Department is now investigating the case. An online fundraiser has been set up to support the family with funeral costs. Another tragic news, this time out of Michigan. Six young Filipino children are without their parents after a carjacking resulted in a tragic wrong-way crash. Husband and wife Ryan and Jen Ambrosio were driving on the Lodge Freeway at 1:30 a.m. on Saturday when a pair of suspected carjackers evading police crashed into them head-on. The Ambrosios had six children, ages 2 to 9 years old. Ryan was 45 and Jen was 43. A GoFundMe campaign organized by the family has raised close to $400,000 to support the children left behind. Charges against the suspects will be sent to the Oakland County Prosecutor's Office once Michigan State Police completes its investigation. And on the lighter side of news, just months after the Hollywood Critics Association rebranded into the Hollywood Creative Alliance, the revamped organization held its Astra Awards this past week. The two-night ceremony included the 7th Astra Film Awards, celebrated movies such as Barbie, John Wick, and The Color Purple. The second night featured the 3rd Astra Television Awards, which was all about television shows from the streamers to the big networks. Film actress Hailee Steinfeld took home an Astra for voice acting in the Spider-Verse, while Film stuntman Jeremy Marinas was honored for his work on John Wick. Film actor Kieran Tamundong received a nomination in the Television Awards for his appearance on the Netflix series Dahmer. This year, ABS-CBN has partnered with HCA to present the Astra Film Awards internationally on the Filipino channel.
The vision is to always create a global brand. We wanted to build this up. We're all about celebrating underrepresented voices within the industry.
To have our logo on the step and repeat on the wall like this, it means so much. I mean, for many years, we have struggled to be included, and now we're no longer marginalized. We're front and center in such a huge Hollywood event, and to have ABS-CBN and HCA have this partnership, I think it's just the beginning of great things, both for ABS-CBN and HCA.
The 7th Annual Astra Film Awards will air on TFC and stream on I Want TFC as a two-part special on January 13 to 14.
And those are the news making headlines today. You can catch more TFC news on the ABS-CBN News website, YouTube channel, and app. I'm Henny Espinosa. Back to you guys at the Rundown.